All right, stocks taking a hit as tensions with North Korea rise. We're on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange with Jim Cramer. Jim, are there certain stocks we should be watching with North Korea?
Well, look, I think that that's an S&P sell program. It happened at the opening. I take my comments from Tillerson, not from the president. Tillerson, head of state, tough guy. I still am a believer that you have to keep your eye on the ball for earnings, but have cash. We have a lot of cash for action alerts, not necessarily because of Korea. I see no good outcome there right now, but there's been no good outcome since 1953, so let's understand that.
All right, let's talk about earnings. Big changes at Disney. They're pulling movies from Netflix.
Yeah, look, there's two Disneys. There's long and short term. The long term is they got the greatest characters, the greatest properties, the theme parks are terrific. They had to figure out a way to be able to deal with millennials who don't take cable. They had to figure out a way to make it so that they could monetize all the sports they have. They have to figure a way to use BAM Tech, which they bought. Mm. And they've done it. It's just, they've basically reset. And all the expectations that we keep having and then they miss may be out. Maybe we don't have that anymore. And that is going to put a floor on Disney stock. The floor is not necessarily here, but I'm not backing away from the long term. Short term, they have to invest a ton. Mm. But what choice did they have? They had to do it. I mean, this makes a lot of sense for them. They don't need to, don't need the money from Netflix. They make a ton of money. Look, they're buying back a huge $10 billion of stock. They have a lot of cash. They control their own destiny more than people realize. We didn't feel anything about CBS doing its package. Obviously, ESPN is a huge amount of money to them. But if they can continue to get paid for ESPN by the cable operators and also get paid another way over the top, that makes sense. So I think Iger's doing the thing that he had to do. But I also think that at the same time, obviously, when they had 100 million subs, they were doing better than doing now.
Well, and I saw you alluded to this in Real Money. Is Bob Iger desperate?
Well, I mean, I think the problem with Iger is that I think that there was no choice. Because obviously, desperation does not necessarily lead to failure. I mean, Tom Brady was probably desperate when they were down 28-3, and they won. So what I'm saying is don't count Iger out. Mm-hmm. He's got a plan, but the plan cannot be put in place overnight.
How does this change your view of Netflix?
Not really. I mean, Netflix, what did Netflix do? They thought about how this is going to happen, so they've been developing all of this content that really draws people. Now, the only thing that I would be worried about is the Marvel comics. The Marvel characters for Netflix are fabulous, and those have been real winners. Notice Disney did not take those back. It took back Pixar and took back animation. If it took Marvel back, that really would have been war with Netflix, and there was no war declared.
All right, let's move on to food. Wendy's posting some nice comparable store
burgers,
sales.
Burgers, there's a piece. There's no doubt about it. Burgers are doing quite well. There's no price war anymore. If you sell burgers, you're doing good.
Jim, what is your order at Wendy's?
I like that Frosty. I like the Frosty a lot, but that means you can't have the burger.
All right, let's also talk about Priceline. Nice beat, but guidance
not so
much.
Yeah, well, the guidance was actually, I mean, typically they have conservative guidance, and I always say it's boilerplate. This guidance was about weakness in ads, about how mobile doesn't, TripAdvisor especially, problematic situation. There's Airbnb, but they didn't mention it wasn't really the focus, but I think it's looming. If there's a lot more, if you order on your cell phone, you don't make it. They don't make as much money, and there's an Expedia price war. So this time, I'm saying let's walk away from Priceline for now.
You said take a breather on Squawk.
Take a breather. Take a breather. That was Barclays' term. I really liked it.
Yeah, that was great. All right, and also Mylan. I mean, what happened there? Terrible.
Mylan's terrible. Mylan is just. Teva, Mylan, Perrigo, these companies are commodities, and they're showing their true colors, and you've got to stay away from them.
All right, Jim, we'll end as we always do with earnings to watch. We have Macy's and Kohl's.
I think Kohl's is good. I've been recommending Kohl's. It's just moved from 36 to 42, but I think Kohl's does well, but the fact is it moved. Macy's, this is a lower-risk bet because they have cash flow to be able to pay back their debt. And dividend, and they're closing underperforming stores. Let's say two down, four up. Not bad.
Okay. And Jim, on Squawk on the Street, you talked about McCormick and their equity offering.
Well, look at that. They did the deal at 90. It was wildly oversubscribed. The stock is down very big from where it was. I think that the Franks-French's deal is going to pay off for them. Mm. I know they paid a huge amount of money, $4 billion. But here you go, you're doing the equity offering. I think Franks, they can blow out. I think Franks is on everybody's table now. And that was much smarter, particularly the millennial table. A hot sauce, the tastes have changed. We know that from when I interview IFF. People like hot. Franks is now the preferred, just like Heinz was always on our table, Franks is always on our table. When I went to the Eagles training camp, what was on the table? You know, ketchup, mustard, Franks. Franks is right, and the fact that that deal was wildly oversubscribed and the stock's up big, what does that tell you? The people agree with me.
Ha, all right. And Jim, before we end, we have your Action Alerts Plus conference call at 11:30.
Yeah, we've got a lot to talk about. You know, the two biggest gainers in the S&P today are Cimarex, which is our oil, and DXC, which is our technology company. So we're coming in hot into the conference.
All right, just about an hour from now, tune in. Jim Cramer, thank you so much.
You.